4 months ago this week, a Cathedral High School co-valedictorian dove into Geist Reservoir and changed his life forever with his toughest test. Tonight, Ann Ryder joins us with this Eyewitness News exclusive.
At age 18, Jay Ruckelhaus had it all, a respected family name and a stellar reputation. An athlete and scholar fielding offers from Harvard, Yale, IU, and Duke. But no family knows better than this one how life can change in an instant.
Where do you want to go to follow the sun? Go over here?
Mary Ruckelhaus was supposed to follow her son to Duke, not to a hospital in Atlanta.
I tucked the newspaper under my arm and we walked to class.
Jay Ruckelhaus was on the brink of independence for the first time in his life.
In college, we would learn how to shape the world.
A paralyzed body is chapter and verse no one expected.
You're in this club that you never wanted to be a member of, and you think, you know, how did I get here?
John Christian Ruckelhaus IV.
For 18 years, Jay Ruckelhaus had the world on a string. A runner, rower, swimmer, and a top scholar at Cathedral High School, he was co-valedictorian, a school leader known for humility and kindness.
As Tennyson said, we are a part of all that we have met.
Jay turned down Harvard, Yale, and a Wells scholarship at IU for the equivalent at Duke.
We will soon exit this theater with neon jubilation.
But life changed in an instant on a hot summer night last July.
I remember everything from that night.
At a classmate's party, alcohol came out after the parents went to bed. 6'4" Jay dove headfirst into the dark water of Geist Reservoir, unaware it was less than 4 feet deep. He never lost consciousness, but instantly lost feeling. His friends pulled him out. Jay does not want to discuss the details.
You know, how many times has everybody gone and just had a good time with their friends? How many times have we gone to the lake? You know, I was a competitive swimmer. I love the water. I'm very comfortable in the water. And one time I go in it, it ends up poorly.
Nobody planned this. No one did this to Jay. It was a tragic, horrific accident.
Jay broke his neck here between C4 and 5 and displaced the spinal cord. A surgeon fused the vertebrae, but Jay had lost feeling from the shoulders down. On a vent, he communicated by blinking, one letter at a time. He asked for a priest. He wanted to have a confession.
How could this happen? Will it last forever? All the doctors telling you that you'll never get anything back.
Try to bring your head forward again.
But Jay dedicated himself to recovery.
Good.
He filters things and he thinks and he plans.
Good correction. Yeah.
And this is going to help him a great deal down life.
Very, very good.
Jay and his mother moved to Shepherd Center in Atlanta, specializing in spinal cord injuries.
I look around my room and see hundreds of cards.
His wall adorned with angels, autographs, and photographs from well-wishers sustained both mother and son on sleepless nights.
Monetary and material things mean nothing, but the love. You know, I'm amazed at just the outpouring of love.
At Shepherd, Jay learned to breathe.
Awesome. Nice job.
Getting off the vent was huge.
And relearned to speak, despite the hole in his trachea. He had lost 30 pounds.
Can do it one more time?
But managed to exercise and move on a body devoid of feeling, with one exception.
Very good.
I came in, put my hand over. I can't flip it back yet.
Good. Now bring it down.
By mid-October, Jay could reach his face and pet the resident kitten.
Tuck this down. Tuck.
But Jay needed help to get a fork to his mouth.
Just towards you.
The body in a spinal cord injury, it is painstakingly slow.
You got it. Fight for it. Come on.
A lot of times I'll read cards, they'll just say like, oh, well, like, you'll overcome it because you always overcome things. Like, this is different.
As different as his second graduation.
You're out of this place, man.
Jay graduated to an adjacent outpatient apartment.
A lot more independence, which will be nice, but also a lot more responsibilities.
In 3 months, Jay gained the strength to hold a paintbrush and move his wheelchair with a joystick instead of a mouthpiece. Every day he's on the move, out to eat or off to church.
Hey.
He is still rooted in faith.
I mean, if we didn't have hope, and I've told Jay that, if we didn't have hope, we wouldn't be here. We would have gone home.
I'm fighting it with everything I have, and I don't expect to stay in a power wheelchair the rest of my life.
The grant offered a chance to see the world, but where should I go?
Duke has saved Jay a spot indefinitely, while he plays a hand that has yet to fully unfold.
It's not what you want, but it's what you're dealt.
Jay and his mother plan to be home for good in time for Christmas, and the dad, John, has been commuting Indianapolis to Atlanta and back again. He's in a study now. He hopes we'll let him walk someday. So that's why he's staying there.
Now, you said that Duke is holding a space for him.
They are.
Is that a goal to go to Duke someday?
Oh, he wants to go to Duke more than anything. So, yeah, we'll hope that happens. He had a 4-year ride, $200,000 scholarship, everything, room, tuition, everything.
Yeah. Well, we wish him well in the recovery.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thanks.